السلام عليكم. اليوم راح أكمل لكم الجزء الثاني من محاضرة Impacted Teeth. In this part, I will talk about the step of the surgical procedure of the mandibular impacted teeth. بالبداية راح أشرح الخطوات step of the surgical procedure. اللي هي this all the same for all the surgical procedure. بالبداية كم موضحة بهذه الصورة. Incision, then reflection of the mucopericial flap, and then the next slide, removal of the bone, as we see here in this picture, removal of the bone, sectioning of the removal of the bone, and sectioning of the tooth to facilitate its removal, and then irrigation and suturing. The correct or the successful surgical procedure depend mainly on the correct flap design. طبعا كلش مهم الفلاب design. This is successful of the treatment depend on the correct flap design. This is achieved by two steps, by the correct clinical examination and correct clinical evaluation of the tooth and also radiographic evaluation of the tooth, as we see here in this picture. Radiographic evaluation of the tooth to see its relation to the adjacent structure, to the adjacent tooth, to the inferior alveolar nerve, to see its relation and the difficulty of the case. And to remove as least possible of the bone, as possible, to lead to the successful surgical procedure. بالبداية رح أتكلم extraction of the impacted mandibular teeth, the first one or the most common one in impacted third molar. Impacted third molar. We can classify the impacted third molar in three classification. This classification help the dentist to see the extent of the surgical procedure, and the difficult the surgical procedure or not, difficult or easy. طبعا classification of the impacted third molar, lower third molar, according to the angulation, also according to the depth of the bone. And finally, according to the distance to the anterior border of the ramus. This is the classification of the lower third molar, impacted lower third molar. As we see here in this picture, this is according to the angulation. As we see here, this is the mesioangular, distoangular, and this vertical angulation, and this horizontal. This picture show bocoangular. مثل ما وضح لك وجهة سنفس بوكالي بوكا أنجولار أنجوليشن. This is the lingo angular and this is the inverted. This is according to the angulation. عن طريق الأنجوليشن يعني إذا ظهرت لنا بالأشعة angulation of this impacted tooth. According to the angulation we see we decide the easy or difficult case. طبعا the easiest one هي meso angular angulation require less removal of the bone or no removal of the bone. Mesioangular impaction account about 45% of all impacted lower third molar. This is the most easiest one. Intermediate in difficulty here عندنا vertical and horizontal. The vertical account about 40% of the all impacted lower third molar, and this is the horizontal about 5% or 10%. 10% to the lower, to all lower third molar. This is intermediate in difficulty. The most difficult one is distoangular impaction because it requires removal of large amount of the bone. It's about 5% of the all lower third molar, impacted lower third molar. This is according to the angulation. The second classification according to the depth in the bone. To see if it's deep in the bone or not, embedded in the bone or not. As we see here in this picture, this is class 1. Class 1. Class 1 depth of the bone, meaning that the occlusal surface of the impacted tooth is at the same level of the lower second molar. This is the class 1. Class 2, if the occlusal surface of the impacted tooth in the middle of the lower second molar or in the cervical area. The third classification here, class 3, if the occlusal surface of the lower impacted tooth is below the cervical line of the lower second molar. The third classification, according to the distance to the anterior border of the mandible or the ramus. As we see here, the distance from the second molar class A or class 1, the distance from the lower second molar to the anterior border of the ramus is more than the mesiodistal width of the impacted tooth. Class 2, if the distance between the lower second molar and anterior border of the ramus is less than the mesiodistal width of the lower impacted third molar. The third classification, and here class 3, if the tooth there is no distance between the tooth embedded in the ramus, there is no sufficient room to erupt, and the distance there's no distance in tooth impacted in the ramus. طبعا حيكون أكيد أقل من mesiodistal width no distance in tooth fully impacted in the ramus, anterior border of the ramus. طبعا classification عن طريق هذا classification difficulty or easiest دائما يكون class 3 اللي هو deep in the bone و embedded in the anterior border of the ramus. This is the most difficult impacted or surgical procedure. In this picture show the most difficult one in your intermediate in the difficult in here non-horizontal impaction. Non-horizontal impaction difficult, why? Difficulty in this case because it's embedded in the bone. Embedded in the bone require large amount removal of the bone. Also if it is near the inferior avian nerve also can damage the inferior avian nerve. This is difficult because there is a risk of the damage of the inferior avian nerve. Also require removal of large amount of the bone. In this case, طبعا راح يتوضح هنا عندنا distal angular. لازم ما نخطأ إنه نميز بين distal angular والvertical. أغلب أطباء الأسنان راح يشوفون هاي الصورة اللي هي vertical. This is X-ray حيتوضح لهم vertical. طبعا هاي مو vertical. النقطة المهمة اللي نوضح بها بين الvertical وبين vertical, إذا كان عندنا vertical impaction أو كان عندنا distal angular impaction اللي هي interdental area اللي هي mesiodistal width. لما نريد نعرف هذا vertical يعني إذا كان أكو خطأ mistake by the dentist, إذا كان عنده خطأ وشخص هذا حالة شخصها كأنه vertical مو distal angular, راح after removal of the يعني after reflection of the flap we see that it's embedded in the bone, require large amount of the bone. الخطأ اللي لازم نوضحه أو دائما المستيك اللي يصير إحنا لازم نشوف ال interdental area. Interdental area دائما إذا كان vertical, the mesiodistal width of the lower impacted third molar must be the same with the second molar and first molar. إذا كان the same, this is vertical impaction. If not the same, as we see here in this case, this is the distal or distal angular impaction. Require removal of large amount of the bone embedded in the ramus distally. نقطة كلش مهمة. Type of the flap. Type of the flap that used for the lower third molar, impacted lower third molar, here two types of the flap. بالبداية أول flap is triangular flap. Triangular flap, as we see here, this triangular flap. Incision, horizontal incision from external oblique ridge, and then end with the vertical incision. Vertical incision, دائما distally to the second molar, as we see here. The second picture, we need to extend it to the distal of the first molar, not to distal of the first of the second molar. Why? If we need more surgical procedure, or if the root or the crown of the impacted tooth concealed with the root of the second molar, we require the more surgical procedure. We end the vertical incision at the distal surface of the lower first molar. This is triangular flap. This is another flap, two type of the flap. The second type of the flap is the envelope flap, horizontally with external oblique ridge, and then and cervically with the first and second molar. This is type mostly for the superficial impaction. لما يكون عندنا superficial impaction نستخدم envelope flap. In this slide, I will talk about the different surgical procedure of different position of the tooth. The surgical procedure, you must remember that the surgical procedure is the same for the all impacted lower third molar or impacted canine or impacted premolar. بالبداية رح أتكلم عن impacted third molar. The step for all position, the step of the surgical procedure or the principle is the same. As we see here, this is the horizontal impaction. As we remember, about 10% of the population or of the lower impacted third molar. This is intermediate in difficulty. As we see here, the principle is the same, meaning reflection of the أول شيء رح يكون incision, then reflection of mucopurosal flap. Any surgical procedure, we must remove the bone. If the tooth is impacted with the bony, يعني bony impaction, we must remove the bone. As we see here in this picture, must remove the bone. Removing of the bone is by the round bear handpiece. Always with round bear handpiece. Removal of the bone above the tooth until the tooth is exposed. As we see here. After the tooth is exposed, then to facilitate its removal, we need sectioning of the tooth. Sectioning of the tooth. Sectioning always or mostly with the fisher bear handpiece. As we see here in this picture, this is the fisher bear. Horizontal impaction, the surgical procedure of the horizontal impaction, always with separating of the tooth two pieces, made a groove, vertically to the tooth, in the cervical line of the impacted third molar. We must remember or we must keep in mind not to make the groove deep, because if it make it deep, this lead to the may have the risk of damage of the inferior border or inferior alveolar nerve. Pay attention for this. After make a vertical groove in the cervical area, we make separation by elevator or chisel. Removal of the tooth, removal of the crown first, and then the root. الشغلة المهمة اللي نوضحها, if the root removed, يعني separated in two pieces. طبعا إذا كان عندنا separated in two pieces, يعني إنه ما كان الروت ما طلع قطعة واحدة. إذا the two root separately, we must not remove it at one. يعني الفكرة إنه two root منشيلها مرة واحدة. ليش منشيلها مرة واحدة؟ لأنه حيصير أكو fracture. There is a risk of the fracture of the apical third of the tooth or apical tip of the root. فننتبه لهاي الحالة إنه إذا كان عندنا separation صار بالروتات راح نشيل أول شيء distal root and then the mesial root to facilitate the removal. Then we remove the tooth with elevator and chisel. Then the surgical procedure, we must, if there is any sharp area, we must remove the sharpness by round bare handpiece or bone filing. The bone filing, طبعا, in the one direction. Removal of any sharpness, smoothing the area. Then irrigation of the surgical procedure to remove any debris or remnant. And then suturing. The other case اللي هي حيكون عندنا mesioangular impaction. اللي هي about 40%, 45% of all impacted lower third molar is the easiest one. The principle the same. Incision, reflection of the flap, mucopurosal flap. Then removing the bone. With round bare handpiece, removing the bone until the tooth is exposed. And then sectioning. The sectioning in the mesioangular. طبعا لاحظ انه الميزيال جاسب where the cervical line of or the distal surface of the lower second molar. الان دائما يكون عندنا حنسوي groove two piece separated the lower third molar with mesioangular impaction in two pieces. vertically, vertical groove, not deep, to prevent the risk of damage of inferior alveolar nerve. Then remove the mesial with the elevator or chisel. After the vertical groove with elevator or chisel, remove the mesial part and then the distal part with rotational movement, as we see here in this picture. As we see here, this is the two piece of the mesial angular impaction. Then must be remove any sharpness, and then irrigation, and then suturing. The other case is distal angular impaction. Distal angular impaction is the most difficult one because it requires removal of large amount of the bone. And here account about 5% of the all impacted lower third molar. As we see here in this picture, the principle the same. Incision, reflection of the mucoperiosteal flap, then the sectioning. After removal of the bone around the tooth, sectioning. Sectioning in this case, in this distal angular impaction, then we can sectioning distally. Distal part of the crown, go on the distal part, remove the distal one, and then remove distal piece, and then mesially. Facilitate the mesial part removal by upward and rotational movement with elevator or chisel, as we see here. Facilitate it removal after remove the interference distal part, and then smoothening, irrigation, and suturing. The another case, edentulous patients. مثل ما ذكرت بداية المحاضرة إنه الدراسات الحديثة تأكد إنه the impacted third molar can change position even above 25 years old or even old age. هاي الدراسات الحديثة. بهذا الكيس نانا the tooth not change position, but the patient edentulous due to the edentulous patient. The tooth or the bone resorption. لما يكون عندنا bone resorption, هاي tooth impacted tooth, this patient have impacted tooth embedded in the bone with no pain. بقى يعني بقى بدون قلع. بس من صار عنده اللي هو كان إذا صار عنده edentulous يعني كان صار edentulous. Require removal of large amount of يعني صار عفوا انه صار edentulous واحتاجينا انه نسوي له طخم prosthesis. بصار عنده edentulous صار عنده expose of the lower third molar. طبعا easiest one because no second molar, no adjacent teeth, we can remove it after the incision and flexion of the flap. And if there is any interference or bone around the area with round brown piece, we can remove it and then facilitate it removal by chisel or elevator and then suturing. Impacted canine. Impacted mandibular canine. بعد ما كملت إنه هو الimpaction of the lower third molar, هاي الاستعدادات رح أوضح بيها الimpaction of the lower canine. In this case, patient with impacted lower canine is due to odontoma. سبق أن ذكرت الأودونتوما هي benign odontogenic tumor of the odontogenic origin, يعني irregular position or irregular aggregation of cementum, dentin, enamel from odontogenic or يعني from odontogenic origin. This is benign tumor for unknown cause the anterior, cause the lower canine impacted. Surgical procedure, we must do incision and then two-sided flap, reflection of a mucoperiosteal flap. نلاحظ هنا tooth مبين. We must remove bone above the tooth until the tooth is exposed, as we see here, with the round bare hand piece. And then facilitate it removable. After removal of the bone, facilitate it removable with elevator or chisel. Also, we can sectioning made a groove. We can section and remove it in two pieces. Also, we must do removal of the bone around the odontoma to expose the odontoma. Also, remove the odontoma and the tooth. As we see here, this is the odontoma and the tooth, smoothing the area and irrigation and suturing. Impacted premolars. impacted the premolars. This patient would impacted the premolar. This patient, as we see here. Surgical procedure of the impacted premolar, we must keep in mind there is a mental nerve. Keep in mind not to damage the mental nerve. An incision anteriorly to the mental foramen, two-sided flap. We remove the bone until the tooth is exposed with the round bare hand piece, and then we can do suctioning. If not remove in one piece, we can do suctioning in the cervical area and remove it with elevator and chisel. Smoothing the area, irrigation, and suturing, as we see here in this picture. Premolar with deep impaction. طبعا أي impacted إذا كان deep embedded in the bone rarely cause pain. فالمريض يقدر يعوفه بدون أي complication. Pile case, this patient need dental implant or prosthesis according to the treatment plan of his dentist. We must remove the tooth impacted for the prosthesis or dental implant. Because if there is no prosthesis, this does not cause pain because it's fully embedded in the bone. As we see here, the surgical procedure is done. Pay attention not to damage the inferior, not to damage the mental nerve. Two-sided flap exposed of the bone, and then remove of any bone, and then with elevator or chisel, rotate it, irrigation, smoothing irrigation, and suturing. The principle the same. هنا راح نتوقف الجزء الثاني من المحاضرة. إن شاء الله أتمنى أن تكون إن شاء الله أتمنى أنه وصلت الفكرة من the surgical procedure of the impacted third molar and impacted canine and impacted premolar. أتمنى وضحت الفكرة لأن هي كلها the same principle for all the impaction, for all the impacted third molar and canine and premolar. أتمنى وضحت الفكرة. إن شاء الله هشرح لكم الجزء الأخير impacted maxillary teeth. الجزء الأخير إن شاء الله رح أشرحها بالفيديو الجاي. شكراً.